seems like the healthier alcohol choice, but your next glass of wine could contain all kinds of chemicals.
Yeah, CBS2's Jeff Vaughn found out about a secret some winemakers are keeping from us.
Yeah, they say that wine is really the perfect drink. Everything that you need is right there in the grapes, but we're finding out something else. It is called the perfect drink, of course, but wine today is more than just those fermented grapes. We uncorked the truth, and we were surprised to learn what's really inside of that bottle.
For over 20 years, Philip Cavanaugh has been in the wine business. The past three at Rosenthal Estate Wines in Malibu. And now more than ever, he says little vineyards are battling big production.
I mean, I always like finding a great bottle of wine for $5.
Cavanaugh says the push for cheaper wine is what's leading larger producers to use more additives in wine. Additives like the ones exposed by Christopher Knoll of Wired magazine.
The perception is you're drinking fermented grape juice, and the reality is that's not exactly the truth.
Knoll calls it the industrialization of wine and says the push to get wine under $10 a bottle has led to the changes.
When you drink a glass of wine, especially a relatively inexpensive wine, you're drinking a huge array of compounds and chemicals that you have no idea are present in the wine.
Additives like Mega Purple to correct color issues, gelatin for texture, and the most troubling of all, Velcorin, which is used to kill living organisms. It's dangerous in large quantities, but legal in a bottle of wine.
It's so dangerous that it has to be handled with special training.
And the oldest additive of all, sulfur dioxide, has been used in winemaking since the 15th century.
It basically keeps the wine free of yeast strains that could start a fermentation in the bottle, or it could, and it's going to protect it from oxygen, you know, browning the wine.
Back at Rosenthal Estate Wines, Philip Cavanaugh says additives in wines are nothing new.
We're adding the same stuff now as we were adding 25 years ago.
But he says there is a clear difference between smaller wineries and mass-produced wine.
What they're trying to do is trying to mimic us, I think, to a large extent. They're trying to get wines that taste like you were doing, you know, small batches on a large scale.
Cavanaugh says that you can find out what's under the cork. If you're at a winery, ask questions. If you're buying online, check the ingredients list. Cavanaugh says he supports industry-wide labels on wine.
Personally, I think we should label everything that goes into it. It looks like, you know, in the industry as a whole, the big boys have spent a lot of time and effort trying to make sure that we don't. I think that's unfortunate.
Now, if you have a story tip that you think that I should check out, send me your idea using the hashtag CBSLA or email me at checkwithjeff@cbs.com. And there's also another way that you can combat this if you want. If you can go to those wine tastings where they pour and there's a representative there that knows everything about the wine, they'll tell you if that's inside that glass or not. Back to you guys.
So nice of you to bring us a nightcap. Thank you.
Need some cheese, right?
No, just the wine.
I'm off the clock here shortly.
Enjoy.